from St. James Haydock as we celebrate the feast of the Ascension of the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Alleluia, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Seeing we have a great high priest who has passed into the heavens, Jesus the Son of God, let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith and make our confession to our Heavenly Father. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you feed us with the living bread. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks. We praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father. Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that as we believe your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to have ascended into the heavens, so we, in heart and mind, may also ascend, and with him continually dwell, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In my earlier work, Theophilus, I dealt with everything Jesus had done and taught from the beginning until the day he gave his instructions to the apostles he had chosen through the Holy Spirit and was taken up to heaven. He had shown himself alive to them after his passion by many demonstrations. For 40 days he had continued to appear to them and tell them about the kingdom of God. When he had been at table with them, he had told them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for what the Father had promised. It is, he had said, what you have heard me speak about. John baptized with water, but you, not many days from now, will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. Now, having met together, they asked him, Lord, has the time come? Are you going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He replied, it is not for you to know times or dates that the Father has decided by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and then you will be my witnesses, not only in Jerusalem, but throughout Judea and Samaria, and indeed to the ends of the earth. As he said this, he was lifted up while they looked on, and a cloud took him from their sight. They were still staring into the sky when suddenly two men in white were standing near them, and they said, why are you men from Galilee standing here looking into the sky? Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, this same Jesus, will come back in the same way as you have seen him go there. This is the word of the Lord. Response to the psalm. God goes up with shouts of joy. The Lord goes up with trumpet blast. All peoples clap your hands, cry to God with shouts of joy. For the Lord the Most High we must fear. great King over all the earth. God goes up with shouts of joy. The Lord goes up with trumpet blast. God goes up with shouts of joy. The Lord goes up with trumpet blast. Sing praise for God, sing praise. Sing praise to our King, sing praise. God goes up with shouts of joy. The Lord goes up with trumpet blast. God is King of all the earth. Sing praise with all your skill. God is King over the nations. God reigns on his holy throne. God goes up with shouts of joy. The Lord goes up with trumpet blast. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. May the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and perception of what is revealed, to bring you to full knowledge of him. May he enlighten the eyes of your mind, so that you can see what hope his call holds for you, what rich glories he has promised the saints will inherit, and how infinitely great is the power that he has exercised for us believers. This you can tell from the strength of his power at work in Christ, when he used it to raise him from the dead and to make him sit at his right hand in heaven, far above every sovereignty, authority, power or domination, or any other name that can be named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. He has put all things under his feet, and made him as the ruler of everything, the head of the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills the whole of creation. This is the word of the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Go make disciples of all the nations. I am with you always. Yes, to the end of time. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. Hear the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew. The 11 disciples set out for Galilee, to the mountain where Jesus had arranged to meet them. When they saw him, they fell down before him, though some hesitated. Jesus came up and spoke to them. He said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore, make disciples of all the nations, baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teach them to observe all the commands I gave you. And know that I am with you always, yes, to the end of time." This is the Gospel of the Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Why are you standing there looking into the sky? Where did Jesus go? How high is up? Is that where heaven is? If Jesus ascended into heaven, might we still find his body there? These are the sorts of questions that children ask. But not only children. If children ask them, then what answers can we give? These are profound questions. Questions about cosmology, theology, and Christology. If religious seekers ask such questions, what answers do we give? Few of us today, none of us I hope, conceives of a three-level world with earth in the middle, the heavens above and the netherworld beneath. But we continue to think of heaven as an existence, if not a place, that transcends our present existence. So why not refer to it as out there, as long as we do not limit out there to a spatial out there? How high is up? It's beyond our comprehension. Is that where heaven is? Could be, as long as we don't limit heaven to spatial dimensions. If Jesus ascended into heaven, might we still find his body up there? Now that's a question to ponder today. The Feast of the Ascension celebrates one aspect of the resurrection, namely Jesus' exaltation. He didn't have to wait 40 days to be glorified at God's right hand. That's already happened at the resurrection. We can't even begin to grasp the scope of this mystery. And so throughout the Easter season, we focus our attention first on one aspect of the mystery and then on another. At Easter, we concentrate on Jesus' victory over sin and death. Today, we contemplate his enthronement. At Pentecost, we will reflect on the gift of the Holy Spirit. The flow of today's readings carries us through the message of this feast. First, we stand with the disciples gazing up at the sky, not knowing what has happened or what it might mean for us. In the second reading, St. Paul explains the theological meaning of Jesus' exaltation. Then in the Gospel, we ponder the commission given to the first disciples and then to us. Go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel. The two men in white garments who are present at Jesus' ascension hint at this commission. Why do you stand there looking at the sky? They ask. You've got work to do. You have a commission to fulfill. From now on, you are the body of Christ. You must proclaim the good news. You must drive out the demons that hold people to their addicting cultures. You must embrace all people with the merciful love of God. The two men in white ask that questions of those gazing up into the sky. And now today, we ourselves stand as an answer to that question. Just where did Jesus go? Amen. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us join our prayers with those of our Saviour Jesus Christ, seeking the Father's blessing and the gifts of the Spirit. Jesus Christ, great High Priest, living forever to intercede for us, pray for the Church, your broken body in the world. Pray for our Bishop Glynn, for Paul, Bishop of this diocese, the leaders of all the churches, and for a healing of the divisions which mar the body of Christ. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Jesus Christ, King of righteousness, enthroned at the right hand of the Majesty on high, pray for the world and make it subject to your just and gentle rule. Pray for our own land and for all God's people. Pray for those who lead the nations, and those who make the decisions which affect the lives of all of us. May they do so wisely and in the common good. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Jesus Christ, Son of Man, drawing humanity into the life of God, pray for your brothers and sisters in need, distress or sorrow. Pray for all who are suffering this time, for all those in hospital, nursing homes and hospices, and for all who care for them and minister to them. Pray for all those suffering in isolation, those unable to see loved ones. We pray for all our doctors and nurses, for all care workers, and for all who serve the community in difficult and dangerous jobs. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Jesus Christ, pioneer of our salvation, bringing us to glory through your death and resurrection, surround with your saints and angels those who have died, trusting your promises. We pray for Norman Mills to be laid to rest today, for all those who have died recently, especially those who have succumbed to COVID-19, and for all our own loved ones who have gone before us. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Jesus Christ, Lord over all things, ascended far above the heavens and filling the universe, pray for us who receive the gifts you give us for work in your service. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Merciful Father, accept these and all our prayers. For the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. Jesus says, peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. If you love me, rejoice, because I am going to the Father. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation. Blessed be God forever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right and good, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, the King of glory. Born of a woman, he came to the rescue of our human race. Dying for us, he trampled death and conquered sin. By the glory of his resurrection, he opened the way to life eternal, and by his ascension gave us the sure hope that where he is, we may also be. Therefore the universe resounds with Easter joy, and with choirs of angels we sing forever to your praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." The same way after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. So, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Blessed Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, Saint James, the Apostles and all the saints, they praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Alleluia, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. God, our Father, you have raised our humanity in Christ and have fed us with the bread of heaven. Mercifully grant that nourished with such spiritual blessings, we may set our hearts in the heavenly places, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Christ, our ascended King, pour upon you the abundance of his gifts and bring you to reign with him in glory. Blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.